We're a nation, but all nations need patriots. So I looked up the word patriot. A patriot is a person who is devoted and ready to support or defend his or her nation. Every nation needs patriots. Every nation needs people who are willing to put it all on the line for the cause of that nation. America, as wicked as she is, yet she's a nation, the greatest nation that has ever existed in the last 6,000 years. But America needed patriots. One man by the name of Nathan Hale was facing a firing squad. And they asked this man, what are your last words? Now, when a man is facing death, you want to know, what are your last words? Because those are the most serious words a human being will utter in their lifetime, is their last word. Nathan Hale said, my only regret that I have but one life to give for my country. That's a spirit. We're not dealing with white or black. We're dealing with an attitude and a mindset that people must have when you are talking about establishing a nation. Now, once the nation is established, there'll be people that are in it that may or may not be that committed, but to set a nation up, you have to be willing to put it all on the line. This is why Master Farad Muhammad chose the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. He wasn't looking for eloquence. He wasn't looking for education. He was looking for a spirit and a heart and a love that would cause him to put it all on the line to establish for you and I a real nation. Master Farad Muhammad asked him a question. What will be your reward in regard to the destruction of the devil? And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad answered, peace and happiness. But then he said, I will give all that I have and all that is within my power to see the day for which I've waited 379 years. Well, those weren't just words. That wasn't just idle talk. That wasn't theory and hypothesis. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad put it on the line. Face death. Face prison. Face condemnation. Faced the most vicious enemy and stood through it all and persevered and built for us a nation that we can say, I belong to. Black America owes the Honorable Elijah Muhammad gratitude. When a man spends the best years of his life sacrificing, that's not lightweight. That's love at the highest level. The scripture says greater love has no man than to give his life for a friend. It takes that kind of commitment, brothers and sisters, to build a nation. Now, if you want to join a club, pay your dues, come to a meeting every now and then, go to the national convention every now and then, and be comfortable. Be bourgeois. Be a suburbanite. Put your children in soccer practice. Let your daughter be cheerleader. But if you accepted Islam and you said you wanted to build a nation, then come on and help Minister Farrakhan build a real nation. He didn't call us to join a club. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan has put it all on the line. He said, I will rebuild the work of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad or die trying. That's the kind of man I can follow. That's the kind of man I was looking for all the days of my life. So it's really time out for a lot of talk. We've been the most well-taught black people in the annals of human history. What else is there for me to say that you haven't already heard? We have been taught by the clearest teacher of truth that has ever lived. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. But at a certain point, Word has to become flesh and dwell. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan has followed the blueprint of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad 100%. It took the Honorable Elijah Muhammad nearly 30 years to establish the business development farms, factories, airplanes, banks, supermarkets. 30 years! Wasn't until the mid-60s and the late-60s that you began to see economic development. But he had to lay a base. He had to lay the base of the word that he had been given that was revealed to him.
Thank you.
Then you got Moon borrowing light from the sun. And whether you know it or not, Black America has borrowed a lot of light from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. The only problem is you didn't give him credit for it. That's disrespectful. We weren't calling each other brother and sister before the Honorable Elijah Muhammad came among us. Brother, you ain't none of my brother. You know how Negroes talk. But he said, I will not rest until I get all of my people to refer to each other as brothers and sisters. This was in the 50s. He didn't call us Negroes. He said so-called Negroes. Big difference. That's what you call yourself because that's what the enemy called. So-called. He said you are the Asiatic black man. So when he started calling us black, black people didn't like that. I ain't black, I'm colored. I'm a Negro, and worse. When we call each other some ugly names from the enemy. But the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, with a tenacity of will and a singularity of focus and purpose, kept persevering until the 60s. When it became common, say it loud. I'm black and I'm proud. Where you get that from? In the 60s and 70s, when I was a little boy, the mantra would go up, what time is it? And the answer would come from black people. Nation time. Where did you get that from? You didn't get that from yourself. A man paid a price to raise your consciousness so that you would begin to see yourself as God. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad changed the culture of Black America. You wouldn't have had a consciousness movement were it not for Muhammad. Be very clear about this. You wouldn't have had Stokely Carmichael Kwame Ture were it not for the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Before we lost our brother, Kwame Ture, I was blessed to be with him in San Francisco one day when he was about to speak at a school there. And he said, brother, I wouldn't be where I am were it not for the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You wouldn't have had the Black Panther were it not for the Nation of Islam. Huey Newton came to the mosque in San Francisco. Eldridge Cleaver was a Muslim minister in prison. Angela Davis came to the mosque. Bobby Seale came to the mosque. Maulana Karenga came to the mosque. So he becomes the father of the whole movement of consciousness for the black nation. Celebrate Kwanzaa today. But Kwanzaa came from Maulana Karenga. But where did Maulana Karenga get his consciousness from? He attended mosque number 27. But he had another idea of what he thought, and you free to move out on your idea. And he focused on cultural nationalism. And we're the beneficiaries of Kwanzaa today. But if you study the teaching of Kwanzaa and the principles in Guru Saba, I think it's called, parallel that to the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and you'll find congruence, because that's the root. The Black Panthers had a 10-point program. Where'd you get that from? Black Panthers started a newspaper. Where you get that from? See, you gotta give credit. You borrowed the light, but you don't want to bear witness to the light you borrowed from. How can you be fully successful in raising a people and reject the father of your consciousness? He's the father of black consciousness. Marcus Mosiah Garvey did a good job. Pardon me, the Honorable Marcus Garvey. Because he, in fact, was an honorable man. And we thank Allah for the Honorable Marcus Garvey. He did the best he could with what he knew. But never forget, it was called the United Negro Improvement Association. Part of the evolutionary step to bring us to the coming of God and the raising up of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Alex Haley learned about his roots from meeting with the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad and his students. It inspired him to research his roots. So that means if you benefited from roots, the root of roots, the root of roots is the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. To express a more conscious theology. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad was the father of black theology. We weren't talking about black Jesus. Jesus is a black man. But you go to the theology schools, that kind of black theology was being taught by Mr. Cone and other black theologians, but they got their inspiration from the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Everything that we have benefited from has a root. Black people started going natural in the 60s, taking the stuff out your hair. Sisters took the makeup off their face. Why? Elijah's truth. All of a sudden, you're getting hip and becoming vegetarians. Where did you get that thought? You grew up on hog. You grew up on lima beans and fatback and all kind of madness. When did you get so conscious about diet all of a sudden? It was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. All of a sudden, you vegetarian. Oh no, brother, I don't eat no pork. Where you learn that from? Who taught you against pork? Oh, I don't smoke no more. I gave that up. Who taught you about that? You got to give credit where credit is due. And I submit to you, Black America, brothers and sisters, you and I will never be a successful people until we show more gratitude to our benefactors.
The Christian religion has failed. Your leaders of that religion has failed. Right here. Now the government of America has failed you. You have no justice coming from no one. Right. You ask, it is written, my sheep, same on the wood. Every wall taken up by it. You want justice. You want freedom. You want equality. But get none.